Hello everyone, and welcome to another Studio Central live art demo. For those that don't know, Studio Central is part of Artbeat Studio, which is a nonprofit organization that believes in using art as a way to heal from mental health challenges. So we have a artist residency over in the Exchange, and Studio Central is our open studio for anyone 18 plus to come and use our supplies. And then we're here today at Upbeat Artworks, which is our boutique slash gallery for our alumni artist residency art. Lost my train of thought. Oh yeah, and another little announcement is tomorrow we have our open house.
Yay.
Hopefully you can still make it, Megan.
Yes, I will be here.
So what's happening for that is it's going to start over at Artbeat in the Exchange, and then we'll have snacks over there, and then we're going to have a tour that comes over to Portage for art making, and we'll have a door prize as well. And the more things you participate in, the more tickets you get. So keep an eye open for that. And even if you're just walking by, you can come in and say hi. So today it's just me and Megan, which is why it's the serene origami because it's gonna be very calm today. Not too much hustle and bustle. But today we're doing origami, which I've done origami a good amount in my life. I've gone through origami phases a couple times.
Same here.
I do have a cheat sheet for origami, but that's not going to be on camera, so we can pretend it's not there and just be like, wow, Ollie knows so much about origami. I think we should start with a box, something simple. I did practice origami the other day, so I knew I was ready, so I made this box, made a couple tulips. I made this funky box.
I love that box.
I also made this vase, but it ripped a little, it's a little mangled. I think it was above my level.
When you're working with paper, this is what happens.
Yeah. But it all comes with practice. I remember the first time I think I got into origami, I was in elementary school, and my grandma and I took out an origami book from the library, and I was so frustrated. I was a very like stressed kid. So let me see. I will flip the camera around to the table.
Just like Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. I don't know what it is. like sometimes it's okay to create something without the notion of having to monetize it. Creation for the sake of creation is a very powerful thing. It's like, yes, I know that these are part of the human world. We can meet, people in society. We are trying to not be starving artists. At the same time, what is the purpose of art? What is the purpose of making things? Is it always to make a profit, or is it also to do something for yourself and to do that? I love it.
It's the fact that the more you feel so much, the more you can do it.
Yeah.
If you're dangerous with that, and you're like, I'm more passionate about music to be
even musicians, they are musicians that are notorious for not having necessarily great voices, but because they put some soul and empathy into what they do, they create art that is beyond the rules. And don't be afraid to make messes. Don't be afraid to do like outside of the line. And at night it was very quiet. And he made a quote, it was like, I think it was like 12 feet long or something, and like 4 or 5 feet tall. And it took him like months to make people very Thank you. I just realized after I finished making these, there was a video and tutorial on how to put them together.
Perfect.
That's
like,
so cute.
This is pretty sturdy. And then there's the hole perfectly in the bottom of the tulip. So you see my shaky hands trying to thread the needle. Let's see. Make a little bouquet. Okay, I want to make a white tulip. Let's see if I can fold it. This is from memory, not to brag. until I forget a step, and it's not memory, but I'm trying to remember. Often I'll memorize like recipes after doing it once, but only as long as I keep making it over and over again. Yeah.
I have a few like key recipes that I go to, and it's like, do like a cooking art thing.
I would love that.
It'd be fun.
I love baking and like cake decorating.
I made a mango cake the other day. That's well, amazing. I guess a couple weeks ago now. I don't know. A couple weeks ago feels like the other day.
You never know. Yeah. Time flies faster the older you get.
Well. And then when I'm sick, it's like I just don't remember the last couple weeks.
Sure. Also, like depending on what you do, time will feel different.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. The only true measurement of time is what we've done with it.
Oh my goodness. That's too much thinking for me today.
Well, today is origami.
It's serene origami and wisdom.
Well, that's what you've done. You've done origami. So that is your measurement of time. How many flowers have you made? That is the timeline.
I folded this the wrong way, didn't I? Yes, I did.
You folded it in a way that it desired to be folded at that moment. It may now choose to be. Like, it can change its mind, too.
Did I fold it the wrong way? No. I don't know what's happening.
It's okay. The origami knows. It's like, this is what I'm going to be now.
Okay, we have the triangle.
Okay, I have made
one. Oh, you know what it is? I did a square. I started with a square instead of a triangle.
Oh. I've made 9 of these so far, so I have like 21 to go.
You'll get there.
Eventually, maybe, perhaps, we'll see one day.
We'll see if I get through this tulip as well.
It's a good thing I'm sticking around a little bit longer today. I'm grateful for this.
Perfect. Now we actually are starting with the correct base.
Yeah.
And not. There's nothing wrong with just going with the flow.
Mm-hmm.
Seeing what happens. It's kind of nice though when you can do it so brainlessly when you mess up and you go, oh, I wasn't thinking.
Yeah.
Like, oh, I wasn't thinking for a moment. That's not a bad thing.
That's how some of the best art is made, I think.
Yeah.
It's just like, I'm gonna see what happens. I will admit, I did not wake up today thinking, I'm gonna go make origami today. But I'm glad I did. Honestly, I think that's one of the things I love most about doing the workshops here is I never quite know what's going to happen. Somebody has an idea and we just go for it. That's so cool.
This, honestly, you should try it too. They're surprisingly easy.
If you can show me how. I'll make a pineapple tulip.
Oh no, they pulled it apart.
I have to watch you make one again because I don't know.
Yeah, I'll go through it again. Once I reassemble this one. Oh, this poor tulip. He's been through so much. There we go. Make another white one.
That just makes it that much more special. You've been through a lot together.
Okay.
Alright, I'm done. There we go.
Ready? Yeah. You fold it. Fold it.
You can just.
Then what if you do white? You fold it. In.
Trash.
Mine
doesn't want to fold in half.
I've pulled so many ways, it just doesn't want
to. It's saying, no, I'm too stubborn.
Fold it in half first. And then, technically, you're supposed to, I guess, fold it the opposite direction for the one diagonal fold. Mm-hmm. But it works if you fold it either way, because once again, it just creates kind of a weak spot.
Yeah.
So
it's, I kind of always just go like this when I'm doing.
Oh, yeah.
But. Let's see. So you said one. Oh, this was my cut one. That's not gonna work.
You want another pineapple one?
Yes, please. Thank you. I just realized that. I'm like, this is not. That's why it's not folding right. Something's
why
up there.
Why is it going in half? Okay. I don't know what I did, but the center of this has been demolished a little bit. Oh, and what am I doing? I want a triangle fold. I keep going for the, what's it called? The square fold?
Oh, yeah.
It's supposed to be triangle.
Yeah.
You do fold it both ways diagonally.
Okay.
Okay.
All right, okay. Got it.
You press the flat sides. Together.
Yeah.
Yeah. You just might need to make sure that it's bending the right way.
Yeah.
So one side in, and then squeeze it down
and then a little bit. Mine's a little curmudgeonly. There we go.
That's okay. I'm missing this one. Okay. Then we fold the corners up to the center top tip. You do that with both sides, and then you flip it and do it on the other side. So you have a little square. Again, surprisingly easy. Flowers are often difficult.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so then you flip it so that the you have the full flower. Part out, like it's still in this, still like this.
Yeah.
And then you flip the right flap over, and then you flip it. So both sides are just the flap.
The flap. Yeah. Okay. Got it.
And then you fold in like this, and you want to make sure it's the side that has the kind of like opening in it.
Okay. Oh, so
Like, yeah. So that part is going to go to the center.
Like this kind of a thing?
Yeah, like
oh, no. I'm doing it a little different.
Okay, you're doing a fancier fold.
I don't know. I'm doing something else.
Just fold it into the center.
Okay. Okay, so this.
Yes. Just make sure that
is that on both sides again?
Yes.
Okay. These are all fancy folds. I don't know what you're talking about.
They're just simple folds.
But it's simple but fancy.
Yes. Yeah. And then you just have to kind of squish it so that one corner tucks into the other.
Oh, okay.
That's why we need to make sure it's the side with the flap.
Oh, I don't think I...
Oh, you can just flip it around, because that's what I did on this one. You just have to... Can I see it?
Yeah.
Yeah, all you did is have to flip it this way instead, because then you'll have the little flap.
Okay, I see. That makes sense. Okay.
Very. Simple fix. And then you fold one into the other.
I did it upside down, is what I did.
Yeah, well, luckily since they're not very, like, complicated folds, they're not, like, what do you call them? There's this, like, flower fold or whatever fold. Something fold.
I'm not sure.
It's very complicated. Or at least from my experience. To go all the way in, but just generally so they're kind of snug together.
It was in, but now it's out.
That happens. So when you get it, you can hold both the sides together, then you blow into the end.
There we go. Or is it this way or this way?
This way. It's harder the first time you do it before you get used to it. There you go. And then you peel down the little leaves. Petals, I guess, if they're on a tulip. Oh. You try not to destroy everything like that.
Yeah, I kind of popped mine.
It happens.
It's loud.
But yeah. It's mainly one side that inflates, I think.
So yeah, I can't really get it to go now. I don't want to. Oh, I keep popping out.
Oh, yeah. That's why you just got it. It's easier to hold it like this.
Mine doesn't look like that, so I can't really hold it like that. But.
Well, like, you know, the flaps you tucked in together, you can just pinch them.
Exactly. Yeah. Well, but it's not inflating.
You have to be like really gentle. I always have struggle with the blowing. Yeah, I think it's already inflated.
Kind of.
It doesn't inflate as much.
And then you sort of fold it out.
Yeah, you just have to fold the petals out.
Okay.
It doesn't actually inflate like that much.
Yeah.
And it's only on one side, I've learned.
It's not a science, it's a practice. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. We have a straight Chloe one coming in. Ta-da!
Hello, Chloe. We are live.
And then we have our tulips.
Yes.
We're a little rogue on today's box making, but we have three boxes and a couple tulips and stars.
And the start of a ball.
And star box and the vase that I made the other day.
We're starting to make this ball thing that's gonna take forever.
Yeah, I swear I just checked like a minute ago and it was like we were at half an hour.
Right.
It's already an hour. So, I'll flip the camera around.
So this is what I ended up with for mine.
Oh my gosh. Yeah, you got it.
Sort of.
It's the same.
Yay, that's cute. That's fun.
Okay, let me flip the camera around. Say goodbye. Goodbye, everyone. We will see you next Friday. Yes, we do next Friday, June 2nd. And don't know what we're doing next week, but I think we'll have Kate back then. So we'll be gifted with her presence. So I hope everyone enjoys, and we will see you next week. Bye.